Hello, my name is Peter Slavovich. I am 17-year-old teenager, and in case you couldn't tell, I'm Russian. Now you may be saying, Peter, I am nice person, I do not care where you are from. Well, you, my friend, might not, but the people in McCarthyville sure did. But I get ahead of myself. Let me tell you my family history. The Slavovich story begins with my father. He was a humble farmhand who worked on a Soviet collective. But my father was not meant to be farmer. He had destiny to be entrepreneur. So one day, he woke up and decided to make his own vodka. After days of work, he finally created Slavovich Vodka. It was a great success. Eventually, my father began selling the vodka, and it became popular at many Russian parties. However, it became so popular that it caught the eye of KGB, and the recipe was taken. My father never forgot. He said, if I was in America, I'd still have my vodka and be a rich man. But he passed his dreams on to his children, as most parents do, and sent me and my brother Boris to America. So now, Boris and I live in cheapest apartment in McCarthyville. Boris has a job, and I go to school at McCarthy High. It was normal Russian immigrant lifestyle, except for one thing. McCarthyville High was still in Cold War. Everywhere in school I went, people would ask,
oh, you from Russia! What did you bring from Ho Chi Minh?
Yo, you Russian, right?
No, Russian.
Your accent gives it away. Come on, buddy. Yo, so you're gonna make a cocktail,
of
right?
Of course, buddy.
You like Molotov cocktail?
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Bro, I just wanna blow some stuff up, right? And like, boom!
I get it. Yes,
okay.
Yes.
When can I get that from you?
Whenever you need it.
Tomorrow?
Yeah, I can do that.
All right. I'll see you.
Oh my god. Are you Russian?
Oh my god, you're from Russia?
In Russia, they wear those funny hats.
Oh my god, I want a fuzzy hat.
I want one too. Can you get us one?
Oh my god, I want two.
Oh my god, me too. Arnold Schwarzenegger live in Russia?
He lives there?
I wanna meet him.
Oh my god, me too.
He's so cute. I heard he's so hot.
I love Russians.
You guys
oh
are
my god,
so
I love
cute.
Russians too.
Oh, I love
Russians. Oh, this is so hot.
Oh my god.
Even teachers question me.
You're Russian? Russian, huh? Are you KGB?
My name is Justin McCarthy Bauer, and I smell communist. Are you a communist? Are you some kind of Ruski Red KGB type? The listening to your secret phone calls, listen in the walls, bug your desk type of communist? Because I know your type, and we'll take care of you.
After a few days of high school, I began to realize how they really saw me. But not all was bad. I made a new friend. Fidel Maestro. He was the only person who was nice to me in school. He reminded me of someone.
I tell you, man, school is a dangerous place for guys like us, you know, foreigners. Guys from the outside think differently. But there's one guy you gotta watch out for, Holmes. This guy's crazy, he's a big American bully, big guy. Be careful of him, man. He's always picking on guys like us, like I said, man. Foreigners, we gotta stick out for each other. He's not hard to miss. He's a big guy. Grande. He also has a beard. His beard isn't as good as mine, though. No, man, I got the best beard in the school. But you gotta watch out for him. Because he will come after you, man. And when he does, I'm gonna help you. I'm not gonna be there, but you know. You can't beat him, because you can't. He's way bigger. You can't beat that guy, no. You can't beat him, you gotta outsmart him, Holmes. Now, you probably say, how do I outsmart him? How do I find his weakness? I'll tell you his weakness. Me, amigo. I don't know why. He really hates me, man. One mention of me, and he forgets everything. Just mention my name, he'll forget about you, he'll forget about everything else. He'll try to go for me, man. He'll go for me, he goes crazy. I don't know why. He hates me, man. Which I knew, I don't know what I did to him. So if you're ever in trouble with him, you just mention my name, he'll forget all about you. Go for poor old me. Hey, I'm a friend, is what I do. I stand up for you.
Hey, what's up?
School days continued as regular.
Good. How was your weekend? Was
nothing special good. Happened until the day I saw her.
Yeah.
Alejandro guy.
Who's she?
And if it was like Auburn, a different.
Which one?
That one.
You though, but whatever, you know.
Oh, that's Natalie.
Why are you guys?
Cruel fate. I fell in love with a commie-hating American girl. Over the next week, I kept trying to approach her, but something went wrong.
Where do you think you're going, commie?
Uh-oh.
Just mention my name, he'll forget about you, he'll forget about everything else, and try to go for me, man.
Look, Fidel!
What?
I got away, but I lost my chance to talk to her. I would see her again. Again. And again.
Yeah, you see what I mean? So yeah. Yo, I got this tattoo though. Yeah, you like it? Yeah, it costs about $50.
Wow, it's really nice. It's impressive. Thanks,
but I would never have courage to speak with her.
Pass before my eyes.
As I lay there, I thought about school, my friends, my enemies, but mostly about her.
Yo, wake up. Yo, you got those Molotovs? Yo, we're gonna blow some shit up tonight. Right now. I need them. You got them?
How did you get into here? How'd you get into my house? Get out of here! Get out!
Alright, let's chill. I'll come back tomorrow. Alright.
Hey, did you get it?
No, I ain't got it.
Damn.
I was hanging with Fidel, but I didn't hear anything he was saying. All I could think about was her.
Ego. It's so quiet. What's the problem, man?
No, it's nothing. It's nothing.
Man, tell me there.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry.
I'm here for you, amigo. Tell me.
Thank you, but no, it's okay.
Come on. Tell me. What is it?
It's just a girl.
Muchacha, eh? Amigo's moving up in the world, eh? You few weeks here and you already got yourself a girl? Nice, amigo. Nice. What's her name?
No, come on.
Tell Fidel.
No.
Tell Fidel. It's okay. Amigo, you must tell Fidel. Fine. You insist? I won't insist. I'm a good friend. Either you keep her name a secret for now. Because I'm a good amigo, you know. I'm not going to ask too many questions. But you got to let me know what the problem is. What's the problem between you and this girl, huh?
I don't know what my problem is. It's just maybe because I can't talk to her. It's every time I try, I get this weird feeling, and I just can't do it. Maybe I'm just shy.
You are too shy, amigo. Same problem as you, man. Same problem. When I was a kid, my papi always told me, son, you're never gonna get big unless you get out there and take risks. Be confident. Grab life by the cojones. And I did. Where I am now. Fine cigars, cool suit, chilling at a... an alright school, amigo. I got it good. You know why? Because I take risks. I take risks, man. I know what to do. I'm thinking if you take risks too, you're gonna get this girl. I mean, how do you know she doesn't like you if you don't ask? You gotta go up to her. You gotta grab life by the cojones. Not her cojones, man, because she shouldn't have cojones. But you gotta grab life by the cojones. Take charge. If I were you, I'd talk to the girl. Just my few words of wisdom.
There was wisdom in his smoky words. He was right. How could there be glory without the risks? I was going to go and talk to her. I was going to take that risk.
Hey, you're not fooling me again this time, Tommy.
Why you pick on me all the time? Well, I never did anything to you. All I am is just a Russian boy. Say I made fun of you for being Irish or something.
I am Irish. Oh, I'm sorry, laddie.
You didn't hurt me?
I know too what it's like to be discriminated against. I didn't know it was like that. Can you ever forgive me?
Yes, I can.
You can?
I got to go.
I'm so sorry.
Can you
have to go?
Yes, I friend
him. You're a friend of me?
Yes, I friend him.
I'm sorry. You go get him, Wiley.
Hey! I'm Peter. It's nice to meet you.
I'm Natalie. It's nice to meet you too. What is that accent you have?
It's Russian.
Russian? That's really cool.
You have no problem?
No. See, my real name is Natalia.
Really?
Yeah. Я думаю, ты даже очень симпатичный.